I want to protect myself from the dangers of Bloxburg.
Hey everyone, so last time I built a secure house, I got a few comments saying that people still get in using the skydiving hack. Well, not really a hack, but they can use skydiving to get over the edge of my house, and they were right. So today I'm gonna make another house. I'm gonna try and secure it even better than I did last time, and that's why, yes, if you saw it quickly, that's why my house is called Bunker House. So let's go into build mode. I have a 515k, so I hope I have enough for this build. I still need to clean out some plots. Okay, first step, very important. We need an elevator, because I feel like elevators are the only way to actually be safe and people not go to your higher floors, because if you use stairs, people can still go to the other floors, and then you're in trouble because they can get in. So let's make this a safe area. So 3 stories high, I think that will be enough. Maybe let's go up to the 4th floor, just to be safe. And then what is the cheapest elevator that we can get? It's this one. But of course, we have to go up. So that is $60,000 that we are going to lose just to go up to our house. That's quite a lot of money, but it's so going to be worth it. Maybe I should have put the elevator a little bit further, because I do want it to enter into my house. And my house has to be a little bit in the back of my plot for what I want to do, of course. You know what? I'm not even gonna put a wall around it. This is too much work. And then of course, you can choose what kind of house you want to build on that floor. I don't want it to be too big, because I feel like I will get lost in my own house. So let's just go for a very simple house here that we can edit later or whatever. Kind of want to make like a barn or something like that. Seems like a fun idea. So this will be my barn. There we go. That's my house. And then of course we need a roof on that. Yes, that's my beautiful barn. I think I made a tiny mistake here. What a lovely house we have here. There we go. That's a very simple version of a house. I just wanted something on top of there. I'm gonna add a current floor that I will remove later. Wow, we already lost over 50k on this one. And then of course, same thing, I'm going to create a mountain around my house, just like I did in the previous video. So using the mansard roof and going into manual placement, and then just create the shape that you want, basically. And then at the end, you connect all of the dots to the side of your plot. This is gonna be so expensive. Oh no, we forgot to add a wall to the side. Okay, let's not. Yeah. So first you add a wall, because if you are gonna drag the roof down a little bit, you don't want the back side of it to go down as well, so you want it to be against the roof. Not a wall, oh my god. And then same thing, connecting the dots. Hope this time it works. And of course you want to go all the way up to the wall height and drag it down just a little bit. And now because we have walls, it will not go down on this side, so it will stay up like that, which is what I wanted. And then of course I need to connect these dots as well. And that's about right. And then of course you can choose what type of ground that you want in your house. So maybe sand this time, so that we kind of live in a desert like that. Now I'm gonna go for a foresty area. So maybe a darker grass, because the sand, I don't know. I think this is pretty cute with the sandy mountains, but I'm gonna change it to like a more natural, darker color. And then of course we have to secure the base from the outside, so I will create another set of walls. And honestly, I wish we had glass walls, but it's all right. And then on top of that, we're gonna spend some more money. I'm going to be going for a glass roof, but you can choose whatever you want, basically, so that we're all caved in like that. And then on the sides, a plot is 50 by 50, so I will have to count. I want to have windows. That's gonna be so costly though. So the 3 by 3 windows, just like that, but I do want to start in the middle and go out from there. So a wall is $8, so 25 times 8 is 160, and then 40 is $200. There we go, and the window has to be in the middle of that. That's one side done, and now I need to do all of the other sides. Okay, so far so good. However, since I was placing windows, I was thinking I want my house to be able to be full on secure and full on a bunker. So I'll switch out the glass roof for a normal one, for a closed one. The flat roof, of course, because that's the cheapest option. So that will cost me $15,000. And then to the side of all of the windows right here, but as you can see, it's quite dark inside. Is it like that when you go out of build mode as well? Maybe I will have to keep the glass roof. But I was gonna add curtains or blinds to all of my windows so that I could create my own bunker. Go to floor 4. I must say though, you do have a beautiful view of the city center. So that's a very good thing. You're actually very high up, so you're very secured. But I might actually go for the glass roof. I'm still not sure yet. Let's wait for daylight to come. But the view here is so amazing. So the sun is coming up. It's still quite dark. I will try and add some string lights inside, see how that works out. That literally does nothing. Okay, I will pull a Minecraft and put just torches and stuff like that everywhere. But we will have to start thinking about how we will do the floor, because right now there is grass everywhere. And if I add floor on top of that, there will just be more grass, or grass mixed with other floor. So let's remove these, because that was like a lot of money. But I do full on want a bunker, so I will have to find a solution instead of having just a glass roof. So this floor is gonna go, and of course we need floor inside the house. Just gonna do that, and then outside as well. So I will work in columns. That will make it easier if I want to change something in the future to the ground. I don't have to remove the entire floor, I can just remove a chunk of floor, and then like that, create new flooring there and fix my stuff. Now of course we have to be careful around the house so that our floor does not go through the house. Because that would be messy. There we go, chunks created. And then of course, just paint it in the color that we used. And I'm gonna try and do the light trick that I wanted to do. So just placing lights everywhere and see how that works out. So this is what, it looks like. It's a little bit weird at the moment. And in my inventory, I still have some giant bear Christmas trees, which I'm going to place around because I do want to make it look more Nordic almost. So just using the light and placing it over it, I knew I would be able to use them someday. That's why I stocked them up so much. It looks quite funky from the bottom, I must say, but let's go inside and let's see how light it actually is. Okay, we are finally here. I think it is still quite dark. Well, it's dark outside as well, but it's too dark for my liking, so I will add some more lights to this. But the view, though, is so spectacular. So, of course, you can prevent all of that by adding in a glass roof, but I want it to be full-on bunker. I want to protect myself from the dangers of Bloxburg. I may have gone a little bit overboard, but I'm actually excited to see the result. And like, honestly, if I had a glass roof, so much would have been fixed, but I do not want people to look inside in any way, shape, or form, so that's why I wanted to make a bunker. But of course, if you want to keep it easy, add a glass roof. Please, please do. Okay, this is so light now. There's still some darker areas, like right here, but there's definitely a lot of light now. You can definitely look around very well, find your way around it. The sun will come up in a minute, so we'll see how that looks. Of course, what you could do as well is build your house in the corner over here and use the big windows in your house so that you can still see everything from the town. That would be so amazing as well. And while it's becoming daylight, I will start adding my curtains to every single one of the windows. Just the privacy blind is what I'm looking for. Oh, and daylight is here, so we can go inside. Wait, is it? Yeah, it is. Okay, so we can go inside and check out what it looks like. Of course, we are at the mountain, so it's gonna be quite dark still. But this is a dark spot anyways. Okay, I feel like we do get a lot of light inside. Now, there are still some dark areas, but this is very, very cozy. And of course, if I built my house a little bit closer to the edge instead of in the middle of my plot, and I built my house to the windows over here, it would have been lighter already as well. But I feel like this is quite good, not gonna lie. And of course, if you have a glass roof, then you can make it even lighter if you want to, but as I said many, many times before, I don't want people to lure inside from up top using the hang gliders. Of course, you can close all of these as well if you want to make it super dark and super private, but we don't need to do that right now as we're alone in a private server, so let's keep them open. And then all we have left to do is do the outside of the house. Oh, there's a tree popping through the roof here. Let's remove that one. And we want to camouflage ourselves. So let's create a nice camouflage color so that no one can see us. I think that is a good camouflage. Yes, this looks like a very good camouflage. No one can ever tell that someone is trying to hide in here. Let's add a garage so that we can at least enter the house. That would be useful. All right, and I think for now that we are done. Wait, let me change the ceiling. Okay, now I think we are done. So let's check out what it looks like from the outside. An absolute horrendous mess that people will try to avoid at all costs. So that's good. That's quite chill. You can relax on that point. And going inside, you have one big room that leads to an elevator. Taking the elevator up, and you enter your lovely tiny house. And if you open the door, you are welcomed by your bunker filled with lights. Of course, you can fix that with adding a glass roof, but I think it's quite cozy. That is always a little bit dark in here. And then over here, you have the best views of the city, of course. And if someone comes to your door, you can always close all of the blinds around the windows over here. So I think this house is a lot more secure than my previous thing that I built just outside with these mountains that I created. So I don't think there's any way you can glitch in unless you do a fly hack or whatever, but I think this is the most secure house on Bloxburg. Now I'm gonna leave it at this. If you want to create something like that, of course, you can go ahead and do it. If you build it, I suggest going for a glass roof, as stated many, many times before, because right now it is quite dark. I don't mind it, but I know a lot of people will. Now I'm gonna leave it at this. The house value for this is $304,000, so definitely quite expensive. But you have a bunker, you won't be bothered at all by anyone, so that's a good thing. Oh, and before I leave, let me show you what it looks like in build mode so that you can see it with the lights on. So this is what it looks like. Of course, you can detail it a lot more if you remove the roof, turning on this. If you remove the roof, then of course, it will be a lot lighter. Let me actually add a glass roof so that you can see how easy it will be. So then this is what it would look like with a glass roof on top of it. Of course, I did not paint the glass roof. You can paint it in a different color if you want. I'm gonna actually try white or maybe a darker color. And so that's what it would look like with a glass roof. Of course, if you don't want people to land on your glass roof and look inside or something like that, then I suggest going for the other roof. You do not need all of the lights if you use that. So definitely a lot better light-wise. You can still close all of the blinds to the windows over here. But of course, if people land on your roof with hang gliders, they can look inside and see everything. So it's up to you as to what you want to do and how secure you want it. I'm definitely going for the full-on bunker look without the glass roof because that's what I want. Now anyways, gonna leave it at this. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit that like button and please subscribe.